Okay guys, this is a very old keris and the Malay weapon weaponry.
Traditional weapon.
Okay. A traditional Malay weapon, okay. Last time they used to defend themselves, protect with carry board. So now it become an art form. And what I like to show you is the hulu or the handle. Hulu, what do you think this material is this, bro?
Well, I think it may not be ivory, it looks like ivory, but I think it's more of animal horn.
Animal horn,
Or bone, maybe. You see the crack here, it could be a bone.
Or could it be a horn or a deer horn? Could be also.
Maybe
bro,
deer horn.
This part, look, you turn this way. Uh-huh. Okay, it looks like a mouth. It's like some kind of lion.
Yeah.
If you look this way, up. Okay, you hold. You see?
It looks correct, yes.
Head or something like that.
It's comfortable to hold, but it looks like a mystical animal. It could be. It looks like a body.
Like, just like a dragon. Yes,
body and the head.
The head.
Normally.
Like macam gini,
correct. Yeah. Like that. Okay. Yeah, it's mystical.
A mystical animal, just like phoenix or lion or a bird or mystical bird.
Right. It could be. It could be a mystical. It looks like a lion also, or a tiger. There is a mouth and eyes.
Yeah, this is making the eyes.
It could be. It could. It looks like a dragon.
So the person that craft it very artistic lah.
It's beautiful. It's a very beautiful craftsmanship. It's beautiful. People don't do this anymore.
Estimated. Yeah. How old is this Chris? Traditional weapon.
I think it's definitely more than 50 years.
More than 50
so
years.
So it could be 100 maybe.
100. Probably they could have used it in some way to defend themselves. Maybe
it's possible also.
So this keris or Malay traditional weapons currently is used during our wedding. Malay wedding. The groom. The groom. Will put or they dress in Malay traditional. Then they put. So it's no longer used in normal.
Nowadays but, they use a very simple.
Basic
traditional keris. But this is definitely somebody who can be very proud to own it. The way it's carved, you know. There is weight in this keris. So it's if you look at it, it's not those Damascus steel, but it doesn't look it's a Damascus steel. But last time, they could have used also like maybe Damascus style. But traditionally, last time, if I heard from my parents, because he's from Java, they say last time those priests. When they make this keris, they use their own hands. They don't knock with any metal. Use the hand. They use their thumb
to press.
Some people believe they could have got some keris with an imprint of the thumb.
That's interesting. The older generation, they are stronger. Physically.
Correct.
Because what they went through or the things that they have. Look at the pyramid. How they built those temple the Borobudur,
correct?
It's amazing. We are still thinking, how they without those machine?
People say, could it be an alien who built that?
Yes, correct. And when you say it press, it's really nothing, you know. Because now we like we call what strawberry generation, very soft. So which country you think this craze come from? Roughly, maybe around this region or?
Definitely around this region, but I can't. Finger whether it's Indonesian or Malaysian, but I think it's not Malaysian.
Most likely no.
Most likely it's not because Malaysian don't believe in some mystery beast. Beast, all these things they don't. But Indonesian because originally they are Hindu tradition, so it's possible it comes from Indonesia or the islands. But not Malaysia, I think.
But you said just now earlier, there's also keris made in Thailand, Patani.
Yes.
Or even Philippines, Moro, or Vietnam.
All these clusters of Malay peninsulas or roots, like in Philippines, the Sulu Islands are all from Sabah, you know, during the war, they ran away. They have the Sultan there, Sultan of Sulu. The Moro are Malays, actually. They have beautiful crests. Uh-huh. I've seen in YouTube also.
Yes.
The Pattani in Thailand, the southern Thailand, they are Malays from the Kelantan region.
Oh, region, huh?
And they make beautiful kris hill, the hulu kris.
And beautiful. Those the curved one, like snake, but this is more to straight, or is it
correct.
Over time it becomes
no,
straight?
No, no. I think this is not the, they call it lobe.
Oh, lobe.
So this like is snake, not, this is not, this is straight. It could be, that one is more for, traditionally for show, I think.
Oh.
But this one, I think is for defense purpose. Eh?
Oh.
It could have been used for something.
You say defense,
else.
It could be attack also. Ah.
It could be, it could be.
Because back then there's no police officer. When you go out to go somewhere, you have something.
Last time, you see, last time, when they go out, traditionally they carry themselves a kris.
Oh, yeah.
This tradition. But nowadays, people go out with a handphone only.
Yeah, but it's amazing that in like Japan, they are famous with their sword, samurai sword.
Yes.
Correct? So, different country then.
Correct.
In UK or in Europe, they use sword, but not samurai sword, yeah?
Correct,
they
So, each country has got their own tradition.
Culture and their culture, own expertise, their
correct.
Art is different.
It's something that, relates with the tradition, the culture of that country.
Malay culture, like, I see some kind of like presentation or ceremony, like the Sultan of Malaysia. They always like present crazy,
correct. It's actually
a symbol of what? Something.
This one a symbol of
protectionism.
No,
or
actually, it's
Malay word what? Kesultanan.
Kesultanan is not actually kesultanan. When you respect, it's a form of respect when you give a kris to someone. In this case, today I got this kris from my friend here. I think. This is the first kris that I'm holding, I'm going to hold it and I enjoy looking at I enjoy looking at it actually, even if it's old, it's broken up, but I think this is the kris that I will cherish.
Yeah, guys, for your information, this kris belongs to my late father. And my late father loved to collect like this kind of old thing, old coin, that kind of thing. So it's time for me to hand over to someone who know how to appreciate it better. So okay guys, that's all. Thank you for watching. Yeah, my name is Nor. This is my friend that buying. Your name again, bro?
Zanif.
Zanif. Okay, Zanif. My name Noniza. Smash the like button, comments, and share. Please subscribe. Okay. Thank you for watching. Bye.